Bernard de Montreal. Book Beyond the Mind. Chapter 7. Human Naivety and the Mass Mind. Man enjoys little or no psychic protection at all on his own planet. Astral consciousness fosters existential illusions supported by his immature belief systems that are far from an intelligent comprehension of the multidimensional systemic universe. Subjective make-believe is a permanent psychological trap that limits his lower mental experience. He is exposed to the vicissitudes of life because of his intelligence that is subliminally influenced by the astral forces of the death plane. Death remains misunderstood and its occult laws remain locked in the pure mental potential of his consciousness. It is known experientially as a fact of life, but its occult reality remains a speculative mystery. Thoughts are forms whose energy varies according to their source and as such bring light or darkness to experience. They have the power to elevate or lower the level of consciousness towards or away from its real center. In order to become free, man must be brought through personal evolution to realize that the astral plane is an inhabited parallel world, whose ancient as well as present objective is to sidetrack human consciousness from the ultimate evolutionary goal in life, fusion with the higher mental world of light that extends infinitely beyond the death world. Astral entities color the human thinking process in minute ways through subtle distortions of reality. Until we learn how to consciously put an end to their psychic meddling, unconscious thoughts will continue to appear personal, rather than as an interdimensional interference. Astral contact with the psyche will perpetuate the absolute illusion of personal free will and distract the ego from the reality of its multidimensional essence. Free will is but an experiential form of freedom. It is not real freedom, which can be realized only when the self has been able to see consciousness as a psychic territory upon which subtle mind battles are waged. The unconscious mind groundless in the foray. This explains the relentless difficulties of the personal evolutionary process, and the terrible price man has had to pay throughout history for transitory happiness. As an evolutionary being, man has little choice in time but to dismiss his illusory free will and mechanical intelligence and begin building the power base he needs to achieve real freedom. Were he in his reality, life would be otherwise. Consciousness would be a permanent, creative expression of his connection with a non-astral thought source that he would eventually come to recognize as his thought adjuster or higher self. Inner knowledge would be free-flowing. Because of the insidiousness of astral influence, Intellectual pride or spiritual naivety have grown to such proportions as to systematically block his inner sight from the multiple planes of reality underlying his global selfhood. He can no longer fathom the actual organization of his psychic universe as a cosmopolitical macrocosm of which he is a blind subject as opposed to a creative partner. Man evolves slowly and painstakingly because of the endless recycling of his polluted memories by astral agents that manipulate his ingenuity. Modern civilization is the epitome of global human distraction and servility through subtle forms of influence by astral forces that induce humanity into difficult, unintelligent experience. Mankind is unaware of the proper tools needed to repel those forces that suffocate consciousness. The activity of astral forces on Earth today is of such intensity that the whole fabric of planetary consciousness is on the verge of being poisoned by astral domination. The American way of life has its positive qualities when seen from the relative point of view of political freedom, human rights, and allowance for individual development, but its astral excess is culminating in crime, violence, and undisguised psychic stress and misery are becoming a spreading planetary syndrome. The rest of the world will mechanically follow suit until the psychic connection jolts the individual and brings him to his higher senses. Technically, mankind has never been so well off. Psychically, there has never been so much subliminal penetration by astral influences seen in the glitz and squalor of modern life. The war and peace syndrome, the poisonous dictatorship of the drug cartels, and countless contradictions such as religious fanaticism fanning the winds of war or inviting the individual to support capital-driven enterprises that thrive on innocence and guilt. Millions of unaware individuals are losing what little identity they have to fascination with the growing, glowing population of artistic and sports heroes, whose worship of deepens the existential void and psychic alienation. Immense and disproportionate fortunes, regardless of the parochial arguments that support them, are an insult to thinkers in the liberal and physical sciences whose supportive and life-orienting roles go too often unrewarded, if not unnoticed, bringing to question the mind quality at the heads of governing bodies. The whole fabric of modern life is subject to an ever-growing astral manipulation that refines itself through decadence. Astral influences can be seen and measured by a mind which has the power to instruct itself, as it bypasses the mass-oriented overt and covert disinformation that makes up the bulk of impressions consistent with ideas kept alive by the astral world. Although the best and the worst influences seek takeover of our psychic territory, the search for identity continues. What remains of objective creative intelligence is pitiful, wrapped in astral imagery, feeding on a never-ending thirst for domination. The innocence of the human race precludes the claim to intelligence in a conscious sense of the word. Individualized, non-astralized intelligence is indeed rare. Inevitably, global aberrations of every form increase in magnitude as the personality is tricked into powerlessness because of its lack of discernment between the real and the imaginary. The sensitive man cannot evolve with humanity as his guiding beacon, but the collectivity can evolve through him. It takes one real man to make one real change, no matter how great or small. Collective consciousness as a global force is powerless to create permanent real change. Only through the development of self-identity, by neutralizing the systematic obstruction of creative, non-astralized thought forms, can the individual grow and become truly inspiring. The mind has to be explored beyond the socially conditioned psyche. Although it is linked to race memory, it connects with dimensions that stretch beyond the purely imaginary and intellect-driven ego. Identity and real mental freedom can only come to those who have objectively identified the astral war. Humanity as a race is an historical accumulation of psychological and psychic distortions developed through the domination of ideologies that distract the individual from himself. The more evolved human will, in time, dissociate himself from global ideologies and recover his identity, he will take possession of his mind freely, with his own power. Consciousness cannot be individualized as long as it depends on belief systems created for the evolution of planetary consciousness. It requires a restructuring of the egoic self and an alignment of the spirit, the soul, and the ego. Humanity does not relate to individual reality, a creative resource that should serve the public instead of the esoteric alcoves of marginal sciences. Humanity has a global evolutionary purpose in which the ego learns the ways of the soul, while the spirit waits on the historical sidelines for the time when maturity enables distinction between the astral illusions of the soul and the absolute reality of the spirit force. Collective mind cannot raise consciousness to a fully integrated state. Its race-dominated memory is patterned in a psychological labyrinth where unlimited forms of subjective notions are dispensed out to millions of unsuspecting, naive egos in the name of truth. Humanity's memory is a lifeless psychological continuum through which it vindicates its many contradictory reasons for being. Individualized consciousness has its roots in a more integrated relationship with mental planes that are not subservient to the emotions of the mass mind. The unconscious ego is only the junction of mind energy with the astral plane. A point where a fundamental division takes place in man, he loses touch with his origins. His real nature must be explored through a mind frame that extends beyond humanity's psychological references. If study and development are not to be thwarted by emotional fantasies that prevent contact with his creative source. Humanity moves through history engulfed in an unconscious process of egoic development that serves solely the collective planetary development of civilization. As evolution draws away from the mass pool of consciousness, in which it has been immersed for thousands of years in unconscious serfdom, to move man closer to the center of himself. Humanity will modify its relationship with racial memory, and gradually inspire itself with more individualized notions that would have been rejected during the involutionary period of its primary development. The mass mind of humanity will gradually lose its emotional density as the individual discovers that racial memory through religious and political ideologies has served astral powers indiscriminately and globally. Mass mind will grow into a more subtle and fluid consciousness capable of balancing emotional energy and inviting the planetary psyche into previously restricted zones of inquiry, whose absence in the past perpetuated human ignorance of the mysteries of life, death and the universe. Mass mind is equivalent to planetary ignorance regardless of the degree of sophistication it may have achieved through the elaborate and systematic development of its historical illusions. The only creative force that can oppose it is one of an individualized and centric psyche that can soar increasingly away from its gravitational pull. Unconsciousness should serve as a ground from which individualized awareness can grow in order to attain its real potential freedom. Mass consciousness corresponds to the astral dimension of the human psyche. It is not of man himself but of the memory of a lesser god within him. It corresponds to a nature that tends to divide rather than unify. The reason for this will be found in the fact that unconscious thought serves a more occult purpose that is rooted above and beyond the illusion of free will. Its stubborn origins deep within the sanctuary of the death world. The human race creates a state of mass mind that draws on the planet's astral forces. These forces lead to the breakdown of objective and non-reflective communication between man and the universal circuits of the mind, allowing astral influences full control over his destiny. While conscious, interdimensional contact between the ego and the higher self at this stage of human evolutionary development remains inert or at best awkward. The soul forces are engaged in maintaining the karmic bond between life and death. This condition allows the soul to evolve at the expense of the self-conscious link with higher mental planes. It will be recognized through the conscious evolutionary development of the mind that the death world cannot objectively inform about the nature of the mysteries, since it is bound by the laws of psychic illusions that determine the basis of its power over man. No amount of contact with disincarnate soul forces, however spiritual or enlightened they may appear to be, can engender freedom because of the psycho-structural makeup of the death world. There is more partnership with death than we want to realize, and to dissolve this alliance of fear, the mind must be freed from the density of mass consciousness that weaves a never-ending web of sub-mental notions through the emotional threads that bind the soul to the astral world. The soul and mass consciousness are intimately related. The evolving ego struggles through the historical ignorance of its time until a link has developed between it, the soul and the spirit. The formation of this axis is the beginning of freedom from emotionally charged notions entertained and sanctioned by the mass mind. As the ego dissociates itself from subjective opinion and incorporates higher forms of thought, it approaches a freer mind zone, characteristic of the evolution towards higher mental planes. Egocentric attitudes gradually disappear, making room for thoughts that integrate themselves into a creative whole. The ego can release itself from mass consciousness as it increases its thought contact or mental relationship with the creative self. Humanity as a psychological race survives through the perpetuation of its mass delusions. Its members have lost touch with inner reality as they espouse the contours of a collectivity that becomes homogeneous in its effort to provide a vigorous collective bond that insulates the individual from his psychic or interdimensional consciousness. Individuality is sacrificed to the cult of a fictitious personality. As evolution proceeds, the ego develops and finds itself increasingly torn between collective and personal ideas. There is little choice, eventually, but to break away from the racial memory of the mass mind if the ego is to experience a full measure of the buoyancy of its own spirit. Mass mind ties the spirit to a historical line of thought, whereas pure creative mind confronts the ego with the difficult choice and test of free creative thought. The fundamental questions and answers to personal evolution within a multidimensional frame of reality cannot be found through collective opinion. They must be sought on the objective mental plane of the conscious mind. The eagle does not land in the street. The higher mind spreads its wings far above and beyond mass consciousness. Humanity entertains self-serving ideas to ensure its survival within the boundaries of a psychologically compatible field of knowledge. It does not matter that such knowledge be real or not, as long as it is believable. Power, be it secular or religious, has always been concerned with the permanency of its status, an astral trait of its mechanical, unconscious nature. It seeks as wide a base as possible to ensure approval of the mass mind for reasons that are purely political. However, as the individual phase of egoic evolution dawns, those facets of race memory are increasingly discarded as the self moves towards the psychic, ethereal dimensions of the mind. Initiation to individual identity begins as growing opposition to the creative thrust makes itself felt, and greater reception to disturbingly objective knowledge takes place in the evolved mind. We are witness to the awakening of consciousness, solar initiation. Unlimited variations of illusion are cultivated by the human race through endless generations. Since the dawn of its history and throughout the whole involutionary cycle, the formulae have simply changed and become more sophisticated as liberal consciousness has risen against obvious abuses of power against human decency. Even today, everything remains to be done. A long evolutionary process lies ahead where humanity as a psychic race will slowly self-individualize into consciousness. The key to this formidable challenge lies with man himself. The new century will give birth to revolutionary concepts that push intelligence beyond traditional barriers. The 20th century gave rise to democratic and scientific revolution. The next one will witness social and psychological evolution at a rate that will undermine secular and religious power over group thinking habits. Fresh and vital knowledge will call for objective and personal evaluation rather than belief and adherence. The ideological century will be buried deep in the sands of forgetfulness and replaced by a century of creative thinking fully adapted to the inner needs and reality of an evolving man. An evolutionary force snapping the chains of involution. Individualization is an evolutionary and temporal inevitability. Powerful forces at work in the world may appear to superficially cultivate mass mind, but the indispensable need for personal identity and the inalienable right to freedom from the oppression and enslavement of mass-oriented ideas will prevail. As the human race continues to distance itself from ideological euphoria, it will make way for higher currents of thought energy that move past the historical, conditioned, mass mind to release the individual from the psychological density of collective consciousness. Advanced forms of communicated, interdimensional knowledge arrest the collective, psychological enslavement and psychic impotence of the mind, seeking its own creative evolution beyond the wearisome repetition of the past. where mass mind conditions the way of thinking. Individualized consciousness releases human intelligence from the astral power of cultured opinions onto a path of ascendant consciousness. The sheer force of objective supermental ideas magnetizes the more attentive mind and supersedes emotionally charged ideas concerning the metaphysical nature of reality and its apparent mysteries. Releasing new energy into the midst of a weary race of men ready for a new age.